Hey, Mount 31, I had a question coming out of section 7.2, number 69. And I think with most of these problems, the thing that gets us the most is how do we get from this wording to these three equations? I think once we're past the equations, we realize that from here on out, there's a lot of substitution or maybe elimination, depending on the setup of the equations, lots of substitution, and I would say, or maybe elimination, just depending on which method you use. But I think the thing that we struggle with the most, like I said, was how do I get from here to here? So let's try and focus on that. So let's read through this. If I jump to the end, it says, I want to just focus on the question. It says, what percent of the endangered species come from mammals, birds, and fish? So that's why you see me calling X, Y, and Z the percent of mammals, the percent of birds, the percent of fish, because that's what I'm being asked to solve for. So once I look at this, I see, well, I definitely have three variables. And anytime I have three variables, that means I need to find three equations so that I can solve them. So let's take a look at what we have. It's saying at one time there were 398 species of animals that were endangered. The top groups were mammals, birds, and fish, which comprised 55% of the endangered species. So let me just change colors here. We know that mammals, fish, and birds comprise 55% of that 398 number. But since I'm being asked to solve for percentages, I'm going to keep it as percentages. So that sentence, that mammals, birds, and fish comprise 55% of the total number of endangered or total endangered species, I'm going to translate into this equation that X plus Y plus Z is equal to 55. All right. And so then when we move on to the next sentence, it says birds accounted for 0.7% more than fish. So I see birds here. So I'm going to be using a Y. And I see 0.7%. So I'll remember that number. I see fish. Right, so I also know I'm going to use a Z, and really the other key piece is this more. That indicates addition. So as we look at our second equation, we have birds accounted for 0.7% more than fish. And that's where I'm getting this second equation. And then as we go to the next part of that sentence, it says fish accounted for 1.5% more than mammals. All right, so fish, so if we think of fish, we've got a Z that's going to be involved. We've got 1.5%, we'll remember that number. We've got mammals, mammals is X. And then again, we have this more, that indicates addition. So as I start to do this, we've got that the percent of fish or fish accounted for 1.5% more than mammals. And that's where this third equation is coming from. And after that, it's a bunch of substitution. So what I wind up doing is I'll sub Y in here with Z plus 0.7, and then I'll substitute Z in here with X plus 1.5, and I just keep on going and keep on going. Like I said, there is a lot of substitution, and I don't think that tends to be the part that we struggle with. I always think, like I said, it's how did I get to these three equations from the word problem. So after I do all of my substitution, there's Z, there's Y, and there is X. So we can see the different percentages that the birds, mammals, and fish make up. All right. Thanks so much, everyone. Bye.